The comprehensive document is a joint initiative by the Ministry of Public Health and the United Nations Population Fund, UNFPA. It will assist in ensuring that issues which affect reproductive health of the population, specifically women, are dealt with professionally. It also addresses matters such as age of consent for intercourse, child marriages, forced marriages, and underage sexual activities, among other issues.
This policy that we are launching here today is designed to be used by policymakers. It is designed to be used by program managers and planners. And what they are going to use it for? They are going to use it so that in their preparation for all the programs that we would want to roll out, this policy will give them directions. It will also help them in the decision makings and speak to the type of interventions that they can make that will better position sexual and reproductive health within the ambit of primary health care.
The government, through the Public Health Ministry, endorsed the UN's human rights philosophy, which stipulates that all individuals are entitled to access the highest standard of healthcare, irrespective of race, sex, nationality, or ethnicity. Chief Medical Officer Dr. Shamdeo Prasad explained that the initial stage of the policy commenced with consultations with several target groups.
The focus, as I indicated, was on some of the existing policy and to look at how those were working. Were they of benefit to people? In the initial stages, we focused a lot on target groups like pregnant women, and at that time UNFPA had also started to work on the reintegration program, which I think now has become mainstream.
The document provides the way for implementation of a complete package of sexual and reproductive health measures, including education and health promotion. Also attending the short ceremony were Minister of Indigenous Peoples Affairs, Honorable Cindy Alicock, UNFPA Liaison Officer Adla Bino, RDC officials, and to show off the St. Cuthbert's mission. For InfoHub, Delicia Haynes.